Good morning and thank you for coming today. I'm Captain Christopher Bergner, the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department's Homicide Bureau. I'm joined by Alhambra Police Department's Chief Elliot Case and Cliff Marr, as well as members of our Homicide Bureau and victim Michelle Chen's family, to include her husband, Armando Escondor, and their son, Armando Jr. The reason we're here today is to announce a $20,000 reward, a reward that was sponsored by the Alhambra City Council and Primetime Shuttle Service, who employs Armando Escondor. The hope is that with your help, investigators will be able to obtain additional information and leads for this senseless murder. On Friday, June 2, 2017, at approximately 10:57 p.m., Alhambra Police Department responded to the 2700 block of West Valley Boulevard in the city of Alhambra to investigate the murder that occurred in the course of an attempted robbery. Upon their arrival, Alhambra officers quickly coordinated aid to victim Chen and secured the scene. Due to the circumstances of the incident, the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department's Homicide Bureau was called to assist and conduct this investigation. With the details of the crime, I'd like to introduce Lieutenant Joe Mendoza, who will explain. Please.
Thank you for being here today. As we hope with your help, the public will be able to assist us in solving this crime. On the night of the murder, Ms. Chen, who was affectionately known as Michelle, was working the night shift at an Alhambra motel where she had worked for the past 6 years. The suspects entered the lobby and pointed a handgun at Michelle. He demanded money, reached over the counter, and shot her as she stood behind the counter. Michelle was fatally wounded. At the time of this murder, Michelle had lived in the city of Alhambra for over 16 years. She had been married to her husband Armando for 25 years, and they had two children together, a 21-year-old son and a 12-year-old daughter. Michelle was a wife and a mother who enjoyed cooking, attending church, and spending time with her family. The suspect described as a male adult with an approximately height of 5'6 to 6 foot tall, medium build, wearing a dark clothing with dark hooded sweater and one dark colored glove. After the shooting, the suspect ran westbound on the sidewalk in front of the motel and out of view. Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department Homicide Bureau investigators Gary Sloan and Brent House, as of today, have received no viable clues regarding this murder. During this press conference, we're gonna share some video. It's gonna depict the suspect, his body structure, his body movements, mannerisms. Those are the things we're urging the public to really look at. In addition, we're gonna release and have for you at the conclusion of this press conference a second video that has audio, and would really like to press on the public to really listen to the audio to see if they can recognize the voice. With that being said, we're asking for the public's help. Anyone who has information regarding the murder of Mrs. Chen is asked to contact our Homicide Bureau, the Alhambra Police Department, or Crime Stoppers if they want to remain anonymous. I'd like to now introduce Alhambra Police Department Assistant Chief Elliot Case to speak regarding this incident.
Good morning. On behalf of the Alhambra Police Department, the citizens of Alhambra, we'd like to send our condolences to the family, friends, and relatives for this untimely death. It's these kind of events that bring communities together, and we are committed to working with our partners with the Sheriff's Department in solving this. Our city leaders and the Alhambra Police Department have committed to solving this homicide and have posted a $10,000 reward in the aid in the identification and the arrest and conviction of the suspect, as we do not want him to commit any more harm to anyone else. I want to thank the media for assisting us in getting this message out. I'd like to thank the Los Angeles County Sheriff's Department for their assistance in this endeavor. Thank you.
Now I would like to introduce Michelle's husband, Armando Escondor, to speak at the conclusion. Then I will field any questions at the conclusion of his statement.
Good morning, everybody. Just like I said before, all I want is justice for my loving wife. I want my son to talk about it, please.
My mother and father met when in the year of 91 in Saipan, the Northern Mariana Islands. Got married in 94 and had me in 95. She was always known as a very loving person, caring and empathetic. Never failed to leave a lasting impression on any person she had met, including the guests at her hotel. Many constantly said that she would go out of her way to help them, even if it wasn't within her job description. We're going to miss my mother, especially since she never stopped smiling. And I do miss that on a very daily basis. Please help us catch this man. All I want to tell this man, though, is why did you have to go too far? So far as to take away an amazing woman from this world and from the lives of my family. Thank you.
Okay, I will now field any questions. It appeared through the video and the things that we've seen is that he just reached over the counter and shot her. So we don't really know because there is no witnesses other than the video.
When he leaves and the video shows him on the sidewalk, do you have any idea where he might have gone? Anybody have any idea?
We know that he went westbound. We searched for other surveillance video. We found some, but didn't give us a clear view of exactly where he went.
The person of interest is a suspect or has anything to do with the case, the woman in the picture?
We'll explain that right now.
The voice that we're going to hear on the audio, that is right before the shooting? Or can you give us a little background?
Yes, it's right before the shooting.
So the voice that we will hear is the man who shot this woman right before he shot her.
Correct.
Any money taken?
No, nothing was taken.
Any reason to believe he could be connected with anything else? Was there a spree in that part of the San Diego Valley and this one ended?
At this time, we found no connections. I'm now going to introduce Detective Gary Sloan really quick to speak regarding the last bulletin there.
Before we talk about the last bulletin depicting the female Asian here, does anybody else have any questions in regards to the investigation? As of right now, we have absolutely no indication whatsoever that there is any gang relation at all. However, it's obvious that gang members tend to commit these types of crimes, yes.
So he just walks in. There's no attempt to rob her. There's no struggle. If he walks in, how long does the time last before he actually shoots?
The time lasts from the time that he walks into the hotel to the time he leaves is we're talking literally seconds, and probably right around 45 seconds or so, 45 seconds to a minute.
What he says on the audio would be clearly understandable?
Absolutely. Okay. Absolutely.
And again, there's just absolutely no reason, no extortion, there's nothing involved with maybe who owned the motel, there's just sort of a warning to whoever was, there's no reason.
Yeah, we've actually investigated several avenues of this, one of them being the prior question that was talked about when it came to serial type of spree in the San Fernando Valley. Absolutely no indication of that. There has been absolutely no indication that this would be what we would consider an inside job or any aspect of extortion. There was nothing leading up to this with any of the owners of the property, the owner of the hotel. This was, in our belief, a random act.
But does the suspect speak fully English?
Yes.
How much money did you
pay? This was an attempted robbery. There was absolutely nothing taken.
They had a safe underneath the counter, right?
At this point, I'm not at liberty to speak about the actual scene itself. I apologize.
Were there any prior attempts, robbery attempts there recently?
No.
Before that just happened?
No.
The photo, you're going to explain the photo?
Yes, absolutely. Anybody else have any questions before we get into the photo? The last photo that we have here in the poster that we have depicting the Asian woman, this woman was seen literally seconds before the incident occurred. She was a patron there that we were unfortunately not able to identify. She actually walked right past the suspect as the suspect entered. Then she stopped, turned around as if she had either heard a gunshot or thought that something nefarious was about to happen. We would desperately, as investigators in regards to this case, would like to speak and sit down with this woman. If anybody recognizes her, if they could please contact Sheriff's Homicide here, and you can be completely anonymous.
There's nothing indicating she had anything to do with this at all.
I can tell you right now, she had absolutely nothing to do with this at all.
And yet she just walked in, obviously heard the gunshot, saw someone run, and did nothing.
That's correct. So what we have is inside of the hotel lobby area, there is a little eatery sit-down area with tables for the patrons. This is where I'm sure they set up for breakfast in the morning and where people can socialize. She was just coming out of that area, had a brief conversation with our victim, and then left the lobby area.
Is it possible that she, how can someone be so oblivious, doesn't want to get involved, doesn't speak the language?
I would say that's all of the above of what you talked about there. Yes, there are people out there who just do not, who are afraid to come forward for whatever reasons that they're going to have personally with themselves, or people just do not want to be involved.
Was the audio of the conversation also recorded?
I'm sorry?
Was the audio of the conversation between this woman and the victim, was it recorded?
Yes, it was.
Are you going to release the audio?
I will not be releasing audio of that, only the audio of the suspect leading up to the incident itself.
This woman speak Chinese or speak English?
Don't have. She's going to speak Chinese, I believe.
Who called police?
I'm sorry?
Who called police? Who called 911 that day?
At the time that the incident occurred, the owner of the property was also showing up for completely unrelated business. Once he noticed the victim was suffering from the gunshot wound, he immediately called 911. Any other questions? Certainly. Come on up here, please.
Come on up here.
Yes.
What has this experience been like for you and your family?
As of now, it's obviously been a hard stone to take on, one hell of a mountain to climb, and it's truly affected myself, my father, and my sister. But I know that deep down in our hearts that my mother wouldn't want us to stay stagnant. She wouldn't want us to stay mournful, to stay sad. She would want us to keep moving forward with our lives, because that's exactly what she wanted for me, my sister, and my father when we were here, to lead prosperous lives.
And I know finding whoever did this wouldn't bring her back, but would it bring you some closure? Do you want justice?
Oh, most definitely. It's, as of this moment, it's, my mother did not deserve this, not one bit, so. Being able to know that this man, or the person responsible for this heinous crime was brought to justice, it would definitely take a weight off of my heart, my shoulder, and on my father and sister as well.
Your mom never expressed at any time any fear of working at night, never said to you, I feel unsafe there, nothing like that?
No. She was glad and proud to work there. No matter what hours they were given to her, she always worked to the best of her potential.
What's your future plan after this season?
I still have to finish off the enlistment in the Navy, and I will be going to school shortly following that.
You mean the hotel will continue, or will it close?
I don't believe I'm at liberty to say that.
You talked about how others love your mom so much, but why do you guys love your mom so much?
Because she was my perfect mother. Yes, I wasn't the best child growing up, but she always raised me as if I was. She would never once showed malice to me, if anything, she would make a joke out of anything that I did wrong. And I always just loved that about her. The positivity in her life was very, very infectious, and I want to exemplify that in my own life.
The first video that you're going to see, and the actual CD that you have right now, is going to be the video of an outside camera at the front door of the lobby. This is going to be the view of the suspect entering, as well as the suspect exiting the video. The second video that we are desperately trying to get finished for you right now is going to depict the actual attempted robbery itself, as well as the voice recognition. And I'm going to take a couple of seconds to check on the second video for you guys.
That's what he's getting right now.
Can you narrate it from that mic that we're recording on as you see it? And also, I see that he's holding something black under his arm. Do we know what that is, or do we care?
What we have underneath, as the suspect is entering, you can see both hands, and as he's exiting, that is going to be the bag that he attempted to have filled with any cash that was going to be found.
And there's a lady that
That's correct. That lady is going to be the person who's depicted in the poster right here. Also in this video, you're going to see that the suspect is still holding the gun in going to be his right hand.
Money down. Money down.
Sorry.
Down.
Sorry.
Down.
Sorry. No.
All right, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Really appreciate your support.